So it's 2025 now, and Carrier is starting to roll out their new R454B product line. And Carrier has made some changes to their new equipment. But what are these changes? Are they better or are they worse? Let's talk about it.
Hi, this is Kenneth with Atlas AC, and at any point during this video, if you find it to be helpful, please hit the like button, and that will really help me out with the YouTube algorithms.
So as you might know by now, we are in the middle of a government mandate to get rid of 410A refrigerant and move over to a more eco-friendly refrigerant, and Carrier has decided to go with R454B refrigerant to use in their future residential products. Now that doesn't mean that 410A is off the market, just that new equipment in 2025 has to be made with more eco-friendly refrigerant. So 410A will still be around for a really long time, like R22. So the big question that we all might have, is the new R454B equipment better than the old 410A equipment? So the three things that we're going to be looking at in this video is, what are the changes in the model numbers? What are the performance differences between the old and the new? And how much is this going to cost us? The new R454B refrigerant is mildly flammable, and according to the new A2L regulations, all manufacturers across the board had to add additional safety features to accommodate for the new refrigerant. In this video, I am not going to be covering those safety features. That being said, should the flammability component be a concern? In short, no. If you'd like to learn more about the new A2L refrigerants that manufacturers are going to start using, check out this video next. So let's start off with looking at the new model numbers. Now, if model numbers sound boring to you, you might want to skip ahead to around 3 minutes and 30 seconds, where we get into the performance differences and cost differences. But we're not going to be looking at every single heat pump that Carrier makes, or we would be here all day. So we're going to be looking at Carrier's traditional vertical discharge systems, and we're not going to be covering the ductless side discharge systems. So the three product types that we're going to be looking at is the Comfort Series, the Performance Series, and the Infinity Systems. So the Comfort Series is Carrier's entry-level product line, and it's a basic single-stage system designed to be economically friendly for residential use. So the old 410A heat pump was a 25 SEA5, and the old air handler used with that heat pump was an FJ4D. Now the new R454B heat pump is going to be a 27 SEA5 paired with an FJ5 air handler. Now let's jump over to the Performance Series, and Carrier does offer single stage and two stage systems in this category. Now for this video, we're only going to be focusing on the two stage equipment because it's just simply far more popular, at least for us. So the old two stage heat pumps were 25 TPA or 25 TPB7 matched with the FT4B air handler, and the new two stage heat pump is a 27 TPA8 matched with a FT5 air handler. So only some minor changes in the nomenclatures there. Now if we go to the Infinity Systems, there is some changes in this product lineup. So the old 5-stage heat pump used to be a 25 VNA8 matched with a FE4B, and Carrier is removing the 5-stage heat pump from their product line altogether and replacing it with a fully variable Greenspeed System, which is a 27 VNA0 matched with a FE5B air handler. And their fully variable Greenspeed heat pump used to be a 25 VNA4 matched with a FE4B, and that is being replaced with a 27 VNA3 matched with a FE5B air handler. And Carrier is also adding an additional heat pump to their Infinity Systems, and it is designed for northern use or extremely cold climates. And this unit is a 27 VNA1 matched with the same air handler, which is an FE5B. So what does all this mean when it comes to performance and product cost? Now to start off with, I'm going to zoom through the Comfort and Performance Series equipment, just because there isn't a lot of changes in between the old versus the new equipment when it comes to performance. The biggest change is probably going to be cost. However, when it comes to the Infinity equipment, that product line did change quite a bit, so we're going to end up spending the bulk of our time there. Now if we jump over to our handy dandy comparison chart, you can see that we're going to be looking at the Comfort Series, the Performance Series, and three different Infinity systems, all in which are green speeds, so a lot of changes here. And in the left hand column is going to have all the specifications that we're going to be comparing. And when it comes to equipment, in all examples, I am using a 3-ton system, and I'm going to do my best to keep everything as close to apples as possible. And at the bottom, we'll be looking at cost. So let's start off with looking at the Comfort Series. And these are the comparison model numbers here. So we're going from a 25 SEA5 heat pump to a 27 SEA5 heat pump, and an FJ4 air handler to an FJ5 air handler. Both condensers are 3-ton heat pumps, and both air handlers also have 3-ton capacity as well. And when it comes to the thermostat being used on this system, it's just a basic bare-bone system, so pretty much any thermostat will work with it, because it is a basic on-off system. Now Carrier is going to be coming out with a thermostat for their Comfort Series products in 2025. I don't know much about it at this time, but I'll keep you all in the loop once I learn more. Just like the 410A equipment, the new equipment is going to remain a single-stage on-off system. That means it's operating at 100% capacity while it's running, or completely off. The problem with that is it could create hot and cold spots throughout your house, because it's turning on, blasting the air, and satisfying the house quickly, and turning right back off. so the air ends up not being able to circulate that much. This could also create humidity issues because the system isn't running long enough to pull very much humidity out of the air. But the key to minimize this problem is to make sure everything is sized appropriately for your house. Because if the equipment ends up being too big for your house, or your ductwork too small, it could exacerbate this problem. However, if everything's sized correctly, it's going to minimize this issue. Now, if we look at the efficiency of these two systems, we can see that the 410A equipment was operating at 14.3 SEER2, and the new R454B equipment is operating at 14.5 SEER2, so a very slight increase in efficiency. The EER2 is identical for both systems, coming in at 12, and both systems are running at 7.5 HSPF2 heating efficiency. So overall, not a lot of changes in cooling and heating efficiency. Now, when it comes to sound levels, we are looking to hit for tat. Both systems are operating at 76 decibels, which is like standing 50 feet away from a busy highway. Now let's take a look at the heating and cooling capacity. So when it comes to cooling capacity, the outdoor unit can operate in temperatures upwards of 125 degrees. Now it's not going to be operating very efficiently at those temperatures, but it still can without damaging the equipment. Well, actually, at those temperatures, you would probably be running the AC pretty hard, causing a decent amount of wear and tear. Now when it comes to heating mode, the product literature does say that it can operate as low as negative 10 degrees Fahrenheit, but once again, it's not going to be efficient at all. Because the rule of thumb is it's going to start losing efficiency around 30 degrees, and that's when supplemental heat starts to become important. So what I mean by that is, let's say at 0 degrees Fahrenheit, the heat pump is operating at 50% efficiency. Now, this is just an example, and I don't have any data to back this. However, there is still a substantial drop in efficiency. So let's say you have a 4-ton system, and at 50% heating capacity would be equivalent to a 2-ton system. So the auxiliary heat would be used to fill in that gap. Now, if we look at standard capacity, meaning the ideal temperature range in order to operate efficiently, would be around 95 degrees for cooling while maintaining high efficiency, and in the mid-30s for heating mode, where it should be able to operate without supplemental heat. Now, when we jump over to warranty, both systems will come with a 10-year parts warranty, so if something breaks in the first 10 years, then that means that part is covered. However, this is not including any labor. Now, when it comes to cost, we can see that the old system went for $8,129 installed, and the new R454B equipment going for $8,606 installed, or a 5.5% increase in cost. That being said, I am expecting pricing to go up a couple more percentage points, so please reference our website for the most up-to-date pricing. Now, let's take a look at the two-stage performance series equipment. So here are the model numbers that we're going to be using for our matchups, and you can see that we're using a 3-ton 25 TPB, along with a 4-ton FT4B air handler, along with the Carrier EcoB thermostat. And for our R454B equipment, I'm using a 3-ton 27 TPA matched up with a 4-ton FT5A air handler, along with the same EcoB thermostat. So in both cases, I am running a 3-ton condenser with a 4-ton air handler, and I'm doing that just to help increase the overall efficiency of these systems. So now if we look at the performance of the equipment, they both are two-stage systems, meaning in the first stage, it's going to be operating close to 70% capacity, and in the second stage, it's going to be operating at 100% capacity. And the nice thing about having a lower stage is that it ends up running longer, in turn cycling the air more, which helps balance out hot and cold spots, and since it runs longer, it also ends up pulling more humidity out of the air, meaning it's able to provide more indoor comfort and control than a single stage system. So now let's take a look at the controls. So what's interesting about the R410A equipment, you can see with the model number that it comes with an A or a B, so 25 TPA or 25 TPB. And what the A means is that it's a standard two-stage system, and what the B means is it comes with the ability to use IntelliSense. So the B is essentially a newer model over the A series. And when it comes to the R454B equipment or the 27 TPA, it only comes with IntelliSense. So in a nutshell, what IntelliSense is, it allows for lightweight communication amongst the equipment. And it's really there to help protect the equipment. So it has the ability to read things like subcool and superheat, and run error codes if it's noticing something's wrong with the performance of the system. And if it's connected to the cloud, it has the ability to push those reports to the contractor, making it faster and easier to diagnose and fix your system. Now let's jump over to the efficiency of these systems. You can see that everything is identical. Both operate at 16.5 SEER2 with a 12.5 EER2 and a heating efficiency of an 8.1 HSPF2. So no changes there. And for the sound levels for the 25 TPB, we're looking at it operating in between 73 to 74 decibels. And for the new R454B equipment, it has the ability to operate as low as 68 decibels. However, on the high end, I'm not really sure, because I couldn't find any product data on it, while it's operating at 100% capacity. So at the first stage, it is quieter, and at the second stage, I'm not sure. Now, if we look at the maximum heating and cooling capacity, Carrier was able to design the 24 TPB to still be able to function as low as negative 20 degrees. Now, that being said, the only way that this system is going to provide heat for your home at those temperatures is by using supplemental heat. So the heat pump alone will not be able to properly heat your house. And both outdoor units can handle 125 degrees while operating in cooling mode. However, the ideal operating range for these systems to operate efficiently is going to be in between freezing and 95 degrees. Now, overall, it is a bigger condenser than the single stage system, so it will be able to handle temperatures a little bit hotter or a little bit colder than a single stage system. And the warranty for these two systems is the same as the Comfort Series, so if something breaks within the first 10 years, the part that broke is covered. However, this does not include labor. Now, when it comes to the cost of these systems, the 25 TPB goes for $12,187, and the 27 TPA goes for $12,884, or a 5.4% increase in price. And again, that is including the installation of the equipment as well. That being said, please reference our website for the most up-to-date pricing. Now let's jump over to the Infinity Series, and this is where we see Carrier making a lot of changes. So the 410A25VNA8 is a 5-stage Infinity heat pump, and it is being replaced with a 27VNA0, which is a fully variable speed heat pump. So they're doing away with the 5-stage and going fully variable. And the 25VNA8 is not a Greenspeed system, however the 27VNA0 is a Greenspeed system. So you might be asking, what is the difference in between an Infinity system and a Greenspeed system? So let's use Porsche for this example. So Porsche makes a 911 series car, right? And for this example, we're going to say that's tantamount to the Infinity series. And their highest end 911 is a GTS, which would be tantamount to the Greenspeed in this scenario. So you can essentially have two cars that are 911s, and one be a base model, and the other one being a GTS. And here are the model numbers that we're going to be comparing. So we have a 3-ton 25VNA8 matched with a 2.5-to-4-ton FE4A air handler, along with the Infinity wall controller. And we're going to be comparing this system to a 3-ton 27VNA0 matched with the 4-ton FE5B air handler, along with the Infinity wall controller. So, like I was saying earlier, the 25VNA8 is a 5-stage communicating system with the operational working capacity in between 25 to 100%. And the 27VNA0 is a fully variable speed communicating system with the working capacity being able to vary anywhere in between 20 to 100%. So it has the ability to operate at a slightly lower capacity, which is a good thing. Quick disclaimer, I am pulling the operating capacity off their data sheets, which is stating 20 to 100% working capacity. However, what's being said on their website is 25 to 100% working capacity. That being said, I am 90% sure that the product data sheet's going to be correct. Now, Carrier's Infinity systems are communicating. So what that means is it's constantly learning its environment and adjusting for real-time changes. And since it has a huge capacity range, anywhere from 20 to 100%, that means it can adjust specifically how you like the temperature and humidity level set. And since it has such a low working capacity, that means it has the ability to run for a really long time, balancing out the temperatures in your house a lot better, while removing humidity and providing better filtration for your home. Now let's compare the efficiency of these systems. The 5-stage was able to deliver 17 SEER2, and the new fully variable speed is able to deliver 19.2 SEER. So there is a decent jump in efficiency here. And if we take a look at EER, the 5-stage was able to accomplish 9.5 EER2, while the fully variable is able to accomplish 11 EER2. And when it comes to heating efficiency, the 5-stage was able to deliver 8.1 HSPF2, and the fully variable is able to deliver 9 HFPF2. So overall, the new R454B system is quite a bit more efficient. Now when it comes to sound levels, when the 5-stage Infinity is operating in its lower stages, the sound level is going to be around 55 decibels. However, when it's operating in 100% capacity, the sound levels is going to be closer to 72 decibels. And the sound levels are very similar to the 27TPA0, which is going to operate in between 55 to 73 decibels. Now keep in mind, the majority of the time that these systems are in operation, they're going to be operating in lower speeds. So basically, the majority of the time, these systems are going to be operating very quietly, or around the sound levels of a normal conversation. Now when it comes to the outdoor temperature operating range, the 5-stage is able to operate in between 10 degrees Fahrenheit all the way up to 115 degrees Fahrenheit. And the fully variable Greenspeed is able to operate in between negative 11 degrees Fahrenheit all the way up to 125 degrees Fahrenheit. And once again, at 10 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 11 degrees Fahrenheit, it's probably going to need to use auxiliary heat to keep up. So the range that these systems are going to be operating efficiently in is going to be around 20 degrees all the way up to 100 degrees Fahrenheit. And when it comes to the warranty of the equipment, most systems do come with a 10-year limited parts warranty after the equipment has been registered with Carrier. And for pricing, the 5-stage goes for $14,923, and that is including equipment and installation. And the new variable speed R454B is going for $16,387, or roughly a 9% increase in cost, which I guess could have been expected because it's now fully variable and quite a bit more efficient. Now when it comes to Carrier's highest end offerings, the 25VNA4 was Carrier's top Greenspeed offering. Now that's being replaced with a 27VNA3. And here are the model numbers that we're going to be looking at. And again, I'm using the exact same air handlers across the board for all these Infinity systems. So the 25VNA4 is a fully variable speed system that can operate anywhere in between 25 to 100% capacity. And the new 27VNA3 can operate anywhere in between 100% working capacity all the way down as low as 20% working capacity. So slightly better. Both systems are fully communicating and is a learning HVAC system, so it knows the differences in between the indoor and outdoor temperatures, humidity levels, the way you like to keep your house, and will optimize specifically for you. Now when it comes to efficiency, the 25VNA4 was able to produce 21 CR2, and the new 27VNA3 is operating slightly better at 21.5 CR2. And we're sitting at 13 EER2 for the old Greenspeed, and that went slightly down to 12.5 EER2 for the new R454B Greenspeed. And for heating efficiency, we're looking at 9 HSPF2, and the new system is slightly higher at 9.5. Now when the 25VNA4 is operating at a lower speed, the sound level is going to be around 56 decibels, or the sound level of a normal conversation. And when it's operating at its highest capacity, it's going to be running around 71 decibels. And the new 27VNA3 is going to be operating in between 56 and 68 decibels. So it's going to be a little bit quieter on the higher end. Now when it comes to the outdoor temperatures that these systems can operate in, the old Greenspeed is rated to operate in between negative 15 degrees all the way up to 125 degrees Fahrenheit. And the new Greenspeed is ready to operate as low as negative 13 degrees Fahrenheit and as high as 125 degrees Fahrenheit. Now for these systems to operate efficiently and not have to lean on something like supplemental heat, the ideal temperature ranges is going to be in between 20 to 100 degrees Fahrenheit. And when it comes to warranty, and if the compressor fails, then the entire outdoor unit can be replaced. Now that does not include labor, only parts and equipment. So the old 3-ton Greenspeed would cost $16,949, and the new R454B Greenspeed is going for $7,957, or around a 5.6% increase in cost. And lastly, we have Carrier's new cold climate Greenspeed, which is designed to operate efficiently in extremely cold climates. Now, I don't have access to this product line, so I have no clue on pricing. However, I will tell you what I do know. Okay, so here are the model numbers of this unit, and keep in mind that this is the only condenser that they offer, which is a 4.5-ton condenser. So there's no 2, 3, 4, and 5-ton, only one 4.5-ton. And when we look at the operating capacity, it can operate anywhere in between 30% all the way up to 100% working capacity. And when it comes to SEER and EER ratings, they're actually fairly close to the 27VNA3. Just a slight drop in SEER, however EER stays the same, and no surprise where the big increase comes into play is the heating efficiency, which is operating at 11 HSPF2, and the sound levels are also very similar as well. Now when it comes to the climate that it can operate in, this unit is designed to operate in a climate as low as negative 23 degrees Fahrenheit and as high as 125 degrees. And at 5 degrees Fahrenheit, this heat pump is able to operate at 100% heating efficiency. So at that temperature, it's not needing any supplemental heat, so very impressive. And for the warranty, it's identical to the 27VNA3, so 10 years on the part once it's registered, and if the compressor fails, then Carrier would provide an entire new outdoor unit. And again, that doesn't include any labor. And when it comes to cost, I have no clue, because once again, I don't have access to this product line. So in summary, we didn't see all that many changes when it comes to the Comfort and Performance Series product lines. Most of the modifications that were made were to simply accommodate for the new R454B refrigerant. However, when it comes to the Infinity Series, there are quite a bit of changes made to that product line, like doing away with the 5-stage and upgrading it to a fully variable and adding a low climate system. And when it comes to cost, we saw anywhere in between a 5 to 9% increase. Now that price will be going up, so please reference our website for the most up-to-date pricing.
If you found this video to be helpful, please hit the like button. We also have free buyer's guides and price lists on our website that you might want to check out. Until next time, have a good one.